Hey guys, we're back. I believe this is episode 12. It's crazy. So basically I'm trying to get a bunch of recording done. Because I head to Australia in like 4 days, which is just so much fun. So I'm very excited about that. Plans for this episode are as follows. We are meeting up with Sin. I mentioned him in the last video. Basically, he's one of the newer members to Lake Loud Guy, if you haven't seen that video. And I just want to check on down here. Damn it, I was supposed to go under there. Boop! Yeah, so he's one of the newer members to the server, and basically he suggested coming up with a shopping district. Now, before I was kind of like, meh, we don't really need it. We didn't have that many members, but we're now getting quite a lot of new members. Not a lot, but a decent amount. Okay, so I need to do some AFK. And I think as we've sent out a few more invites as well, a few people have said yes, so there are also more coming. Which is also quite good. So I think maybe now we can sort of handle a shopping district. Before, probably wasn't so necessary. Now, there we are. And now we should, I think we can handle it. And I think it's going to be a lot of fun. Sin has suggested maybe finding a river somewhere so we can do like a riverfront shopping area, which I really, really like that idea. So we're going to go meet up with him and try to scout a location for that.
No idea. I assume it's some sort of tour or something.
Nope. It's not actually, no. We're starting a new project.
We're going exploring.
We're going exploring.
And you're in charge.
And we're going to find a place. Yeah, you're the leader. So, where are we going?
What are we doing, Croc?
No.
What do you mean no? Come on, you brought us all here.
Okay.
Oh, fine. Shall I take over then?
Yeah.
All right then. Well, as you guys know, I'm pretty new on the server. You're there in all your lovely bling bling diamond armor, and I'm here in my iron.
You've got a diamond sword.
I do have a diamond sword. I've got all my diamond tools. I have the facilities to gain diamonds.
I forgot my hands.
Oh. I'll look away.
It's okay, I'm back.
But I think we need a shopping district.
Agreed.
Yeah?
Agreed.
And you two are here because we're going to go into unexplored territory, and I need some meat shields.
Sounds like a plan.
Yeah, awesome. I'm happy. So I'm guessing neither of you have brought resources.
No, nothing. Not even of course a not. Little bit.
I've got some red hardened clay if you need some.
Oh, beautiful. Well, perfect. I have an inventory stacked with stuff. Hopefully I've brought everything. I even bought stuff to make portals.
Oh, nice.
That's how organized I am.
Wow, I literally emptied my inventory before I left my base.
Probably sensible. You're probably going to die.
Probably.
I suppose we kind of need to pick a direction.
I have a good system for that. Does anyone have a bow?
I do.
Can I borrow it?
You may, sir. Do you need arrows?
No, I have one arrow. So, basically, I'm going to fire this up in the air.
Mm-hmm.
And whatever direction the arrow lands next to me is the direction we go.
What if it hits you?
Then we mulligan.
Okay, that
this way.
Sweet.
So that is east. Great. Cool.
Here, take your bow.
Right. Oh, thank you very much.
Wait, no, did
it
go?
You're just going to run off with it then.
I did think about it.
There you go.
I'm not going to lie. Let's do it.
Right,
east.
And spawn is obviously surrounded by. So we're going to need to make some boats.
Yeah. I think so.
Hang on.
How important do you think these trees are on a scale of 1 to 10?
Don't worry, I've got a load of wood.
Nice.
See, I am so prepared.
You are very prepared. It's nice to be having a father around.
One boat.
Stolen.
Two boats. And I suppose I'm going to need one. There we go. Right, so I figure I'm going to make a cut here, and I'll come back in when we find somewhere.
Yay.
Cool? Cool. Catch you guys in a second. I do have more.
It's all right. It's all right. Don't want to waste things.
Jeez. Where are you?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where's here?
Right next to you.
Are you really?
What?
Yeah.
No, you're all the way invisible. Break the cactus.
Right, I'm running around. Break the cactus.
Oh.
What the?
You are there.
Completely invisible.
Oh, brilliant.
No, it's not brilliant. No. Oh, man. Run away, run away. Hacks.
Right. I'll reload.
Wow, he got the... I know the... Oh, the G. There you are. Wow, okay. Wow, okay, that was crazy. I know the boats make people disappear, but I've never seen it, like, carry over outside the boat.
That's pretty impressive.
Yeah,
well,
skills.
It had a complete hissy fit when we went over that chunk of water. Threw me out of the boat, then made the boat disappear. I finally got back in it, and obviously...
On the
Minecraft got.
On the modded server the other day, it crashed while I was in the middle of an ocean on a boat, and then when I re-looked back in, I just watched my boat sink to the bottom of the ocean, and I was just stranded out there. I was like, oh, what do I do now? Alright guys, so we have found a pretty nice location for our shopping district. It was pretty much the second place we found. I have set up a portal. I say I because I did it all by myself with no help from any of these lazy people.
But it would have been a lot quicker if somebody else had done it.
Yeah, I did take my time. I had to get the right location, guys. It was very important to me. So the plan is we're going to have this island here where the portal is. Then where these logs are here, we're going to dig this through and connect the river and create a second island here. And then we're going to have a bridge going from mainland to island back to mainland. So I think the place is going to look pretty damn cool. Once we're all said and done, and then shops, and then diamonds, and then retirement. Is that how that works? I think so. Alright.
Maybe.
He sounds like sure.
Get some diamonds, quit the game.
Pretty
good.
Much.
Done.
And then we win Minecraft.
Yeah, that's it.
It's perfect.
Yeah, that's the goal of Minecraft.
That's it. To stop playing Minecraft. I think we've made terrible mistakes.
To get diamonds.
Something has gone very wrong.
I think so. Alright, so yeah, I think the next step is we're gonna do that exactly. Dig out this area here and start linking up the river. Sound good?
Sounds good.
Sweet.
Yep, let's get crack on.
Let's do it.
Alright guys, we are back. Yes, I am here. Paragraph. They all forgot me to introduce.
We're
so,
sorry.
The most important thing first, we have a first shop. Yes, it is a shop. It's the most awesome building ever. And yeah, some planks were also put up and a bit of slabberoo. So yeah, it looks awesome. What do you guys think?
It's looking
good.
I
think we did a little bit more than just a few slabs, didn't we? Haven't we just built this? Like, all of this in between clips?
Yeah. We got a little carried away.
It's just a few slabs.
just a couple of things we just laid down, you know. Nothing.
Break it down, it's just slabs.
It's just blocks we've placed.
You know, it's looking good. Creaky floorboards. The details. We got buttons. We got slabs. We got these sweet
lanterns. We've got all the things we need for a party.
Exactly. So yeah, I'm really excited about the shopping district.
Has anyone got ideas for their first shops?
I certainly do.
Are you going to spin?
Certainly not.
You're the only one with a shop, Para.
Yeah, but I just wanted to build a house. Well, the front of a house.
It's very nice.
Okay, guys, that was it's taking a while to load in. It's a lot of fun. It's the next day for me, and I had a lot of fun playing with the guys yesterday. We ended up playing together for many, many, many hours, and wow, okay. That is probably the biggest singular oak tree I've ever seen. Anyway, we got quite a bit done. As you can see, I'm gonna pillar up here with whatever blocks I have in my inventory, so we can have like a better look at the whole area we got completed. I can already notice a few changes from after I logged off. It was about 2:20 in the morning when I logged off, but it was only sort of evening for the other boys. But yeah, you can see we got all this along there. Paragraph's entrance there to his shop, and we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bridges. We've each claimed a bridge. This is my bridge here. I believe this is Paragraph's bridge, T-Croc's bridge, this will be Sin's bridge, and we have a fifth bridge. Aquabuzzard HR wants to do terraforming around here, so I think we'll give him this bridge. And we basically came up with a rule that you can't make a shop until your bridge is finished, which I think is an excellent rule, because, you know, there's no point in having a bunch of shops and stuff here if we're all running across crappy grass pathways. But yeah, so that's what I'm gonna try to get finished this episode and get my bridge done. I am going to Australia in just a couple of days from me now, so I would really like to have my shop up and running. I have an idea for my shop. It does involve villagers, but not in the sense that you would imagine. I'm not just gonna put in, you know, mending books or something like that. I'm gonna have a bit of a go with it. This was just a bit of a prank yesterday. But yeah, so I think we're gonna try and get a bit of a design done for this bridge now, and see what we can come up with. I'm not the best bridge maker. I haven't built too many. And being that this is angular, not straight on, it's going to be a bit of a challenge, but I think it could be a lot of fun. So let's see what we can come up with, yeah? Okay, guys. So put this together. I was thinking of a drawbridge because, like, we've got the ocean here. People need to ferry supplies into the market houses and things like that, which completely makes it, well, completely useless as a bridge because, you know, there's a gap here. But I like it. I can't decide though what looks more chainy. The stone slabs here, coming down kind of like a chain, or I'm leaning towards more the iron bars like that. But yeah, it's tough. I'm not 100% sure. And this part here as well, it just looks way too weak. But I do like the cobble design, so maybe I can take this bottom one out. I might try that actually. Let's do that. Let's go up here. Am I gonna hit my head? No, I'm not. Great. Okay, so then we're gonna have the same problem though, aren't we? Where's my pickaxe? If we take this one out here, did I just do the wrong one? Probably. Go there. It's a little bit weak, and then if we do another one there, and there, and where's my thingies? There we go. And let's get up. There we go, we can walk on that. Glad these aren't like fences where you can't like walk around them like that. So I wonder how that looks. Does that look better? Let's go down and have a look. So let's go over here and maybe we need to do that one just up here. Otherwise, I think it just, again, same problem. It just looks a little bit too weak, doesn't it? So let's have a look at that. I think we could be okay with that. Yeah, it's actually not too bad. Yeah, okay, so I like that. So yeah, it kind of like, you can see it's like holding the bridge up there. And I've got the slabs kind of doubled up in places, so it's kind of like there are, it's very annoying being in the water, it's kind of like they're overlapping a little bit as the bridge, and then they'll extend back down and go flat, and this chain will stretch back out and yeah, it meets up. They are, even with the slabs like overlapping, I did like count them out and do the exact right amount, so imaginarily, if they were to be able to lower, then they would link up perfectly, and that makes me kind of happy. So yeah, it's kind of like, if you guys think that the stone slabs look better, let me know, and I can put those in. If you like the chain better, I'll leave that, because, you know, now looking at it, maybe the stone? Yeah, I'm thinking, because, like, you can just see it's just, it's just too much going on, it's not very clear, I guess is what I'm trying to say. Whereas this, it's pretty obvious, and it creates a nice contrast, and it kind of also blends in well with the rest of it. So yeah, I think maybe I will replace, I think at this point I'll replace the iron bars for the stone slabs. But if you disagree, let me know in the comments, and I will change them back out for the iron bars on both sides. But I think this looks better, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that, and then we'll come back once that's done. Okay guys, we're back, and I've finished the drawbridge. I've changed out both sides for the stone brick, and I actually think it's looking really cool. I really like it. You know, I think it would be better if it was larger and we had more room to maybe make it look more drawbridgey, but I think it gets the point across, and it, from over here you can see the shopping district. It does, however, you can kind of see the shops through there. This does cut the line of sight a little bit, but so do these. I mean, it's not too bad, and really, nobody's ever gonna be over here. I just wanted to get sort of a wider angle of how it was looking, and I'm pretty happy with it. You know, this is only the second bridge I've ever actually built in Minecraft, and definitely the first drawbridge, so I don't think I did too badly. I'm not the best builder, let alone bridge builder, but I think this is coming out pretty good. Again, we've got a little creaky blocks here and there. Actually, that's pretty quiet. Why is that so quiet? Well, now it's probably too loud. Let's adjust that a little bit. There we go. Yeah, that's better. So it sounds a bit creaky, which is nice. I can't put them down here because these are bottom half slabs, so I can't actually place them here. But it's kind of cool when you get up to this top part and it starts getting nervous, and then you'll notice when you jump off. Nope, no, you don't notice. Nope, okay, well, I did it before. Before, when I jumped off, I heard the trapdoor sort of clinking away as if I, you know, it was creaking. There it is, kind of, it's like it's swinging back and forth, which I thought was a cool little thing. Ooh, buttons. I do need to get some buttons on here. Cool, we have some of this. Make some more of those while we sink to the bottom of the ocean. Oh no, did I throw the stone? Get back here, guy! Ooh. Ooh, we have a ravine. We might have to go have a look at that a little bit later. But yeah, so I think this has come up quite well, actually. Let's put one there, one there, one there. Is that all the people did? Oh, I've got to match this one, obviously. I think that's all we have to do. I don't think we need them on the back side. And I'll have to do the other side now that I think about it. So we're gonna need another four, but I'll do that off camera. The next thing we're gonna do is I went and grabbed two of my villagers from the village. And we need to get them through here and get them set up, because in the next episode, I will be building my shop. And apparently I am doing it on camera, so you're welcome. There we go. Okay, that's it. The bridge is finished. Yay, we saw it finished and completed. Yay. Cool. So now I finished my bridge. So GG everyone else who hasn't even started. Which means now, according to the rules, I can build my shop. Don't know if this is staying. Not what Para's gonna do with this. He kinda just mocked up something to see what he did it in like 5 minutes. He's like, this is what a shop will look like. And yeah, it's better than any house I've ever built. Son of a... Anywho. Build envy aside. Yeah, I think we're going to go get our villagers through. And put them in a little hidey hole. And I'll explain a little bit about what we're going to do for a shop. Okay, we're back. And we're just at the portal. This portal goes to our brand new... shopping district, so I'm just gonna run a bunch of rail all the way back to my areas, which is a little bit, it's not too far, but it is a couple of levels different, so I don't know how we're gonna go about that just yet. But let me lay some of this down, and then I will meet you guys back here. Okay guys, here's the plan. The villager is going to come through from the thing all the way over the squiggly rail here, down along the edge of this, and then I'm hoping, I need to eat some food I think, I'm hoping that it's just going to squiggle its way all the way over this part here, and then it should just drop neatly down this hole here onto this, where we're going to have some more rail to pick it up, and I've only got a little bit of rail on each one of these, so in theory it should just drop neatly into the hole and carry on. I mean, that's the plan. I don't know how this is gonna work, and then it should go here and then here and then down. How are we gonna do this part here? Maybe we need to come over one more, and we can put some squigglies here. Just worried about this, I don't want it to get any suffocation damage as it's going around these places. Yep, okay, and then yeah, it should carry on. Oh my god, I'm so stupid. I'm like laying this like, yeah, we'll just drop it down the thing, and I need to get the villagers to come back from this direction and go up. Dang it. Okay guys, I finished getting all the rail in. As you can see, it goes all the way down, so let's give this guy a nudge. He actually took a bit of damage just before, so I'm hoping he doesn't take any on the way, because that would be atrocious. Why is it gone that way? Thought I had that the other way. Why am I so bad at this? I put that there now. Alright, can you come back now? Please? Okay, there's every chance that villager just died because it went under the timber blocks and he already took damage before. Even though the minecart looked empty. If that villager is not here, I'm gonna be so sad. Like, that villager was awesome. Come on, come on. Oh, son of a. That's crazy bad. That villager had efficiency 5 for 25 books, unbreaking 3. Oh my god, and the other villager is now walked off as well. Why are villagers so stupid? Okay, this is stupid. This villager wouldn't get out of the portal, so I had to break the block behind. He walks straight to the corner where there's a stray, just waiting for it, walks straight in there, starts taking damage, and then runs out into the night where there's all sorts of nasties around. Get in this damn portal. Thank you. Okay, go this way. Yes. Oh, I thought he went back through the portal. Oh my god. Okay, go over here. This guy took damage also. These idiots. I'm so sad about that last one. And now this guy's man. Absolute douchebag. Alright. I hate villagers. Get in the thing. Thank you. Go the right direction. Look at you. Being all cooperative. Now, if this guy dies, we're really screwed because this is our mending guy. So, you know. He's like the one money ticket we got at the moment. So, about the shop. So, the thing is, or plan is, okay, we're not just going to sell mending books. We're going to allow people the chance to trade with the mending guy. We're gonna get some other, we're gonna go through and sort our villages. We're gonna try and get Silk Touch, efficiency 5, if possible, looting, what's the other good ones, Fortune, and then we're gonna put them in behind little screens so they're nice and safe. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna sell emerald. Oh, we took damage. Oh, you better not oh, there's a block there. Okay, don't take any more damage on the way. Come on, guy. Just be cool. Okay, GG. Okay, now we just gotta hope this guy doesn't suffocate or anything. Okay, we lost that thing. Okay, he's gone through. Okay, it's gonna be nighttime out there as well. Oh no. Alright, we gotta be fast. Get him into a hole. Oh, okay, sun's coming up. Alright, good, good, good. Okay. Where are we gonna build our little house though? You know what? We're gonna build it right over there. Are we? Yeah, why not? Build it next to the portal? Yeah, let's do that. Alright, so we're gonna push this guy, hopefully, to the right location, and then we're just gonna put him in a hole until we're ready for him. So yeah, we're gonna sell emeralds. Yeah? Yeah? How clever is that? So if they wanna trade, you gotta do that. It's gonna be called exotic books. No, not exotic books. Exotic items. Ooh, fancy. So he's gonna sell these kind of really good quality books, or be able to trade with these really good quality guys. Selling emeralds. I'm gonna sell nether stars as well, because I have a bunch of those. They're gonna be pricey. And ender chests, I think, is the third item that I wanna sell in my shop. So we'll push him over towards the back here and get him in a hole. And then off camera, I'll do some trading, try and get some cool villagers, because that always takes a while. And then live here until I'm ready for you. And then once we get those villages, we'll start dealing or start putting the shop together in the very next episode, guys. So that is gonna do it for me. I hope you enjoyed the shenanigans with the other boys, and I'm really glad that we got the shopping district up and working. Actually, let's go up, we have one final look at it. How many things do we have? So I think we've got just so much done. It's really, really cool. I'm gonna put my shop right on this little, oh, there's a bridge here. The location may change, but I'm thinking maybe here is good for now. Maybe just over there, on the corner. Right there might be where our shop goes. We'll find out. But yeah, that's gonna absolutely do it for me, guys. Alright, well, I will see you in a couple of days. I'm gonna pretty much start recording the next episode right away, because I've got to go to Australia in 2 days. So I'm gonna really try my hardest to get the shop up and going before I leave, and that way when I can come back, hopefully I come back to all the nice juicy blue diamonds. So anyway, that's the plan. Alright guys, if you liked the episode, please leave a like, subscribe if you really, really enjoyed the video, and I shall see you in the next one. Alright, bye!